The anointing has already flowed. What else if you say? Such men have to obey that anointing. Eh? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time. How to break through? Tell your neighbor how to break through.
How to break through.
Before a breakthrough happens, there is something that you have to break. There is something that you have to break so that you break through. It may not be something that is standing in your way as a stumbling block, but unto your brethren or sisters' way. Eh? What does it feel, son? Sometimes breakthrough never comes or may not come out of your personal battles, but it may come out of the battles you are fighting for people who don't know you. Yes, battles, the battle that you are fighting for that sister in that church, the battle that you are fighting for that brother in that church. I'm seeing this sister is struggling with marriage. I want to fight her battles behind the curtains. I'm seeing this brother is being delayed in terms of employment, instead of getting a job or getting married. I want to fight a battle for this brother. If you fight that battle for this brother, this sister, yes, you are breaking through to an individual perspective. What does it feel, sir?
Amen.
Yes, the more you fight for them, the more you break through. That's why Christ said, pray for them. That's what the Bible says, that they pray for each other. That's why Paul said, I always mention you in prayers. Sometimes when you pray for someone, for that someone to receive that breakthrough, that victory, that winning spirit, yeah, the Lord automatically opens your way. Yes, you are in class, and you are praying for that number last student to become something like number top 20. Yes, if that number last student achieves to the number that you have been trusting God for him or her, I'm telling you, you will pass the exam automatically. Yeah? Let me prove. There is this man called David. David was a poor man. Not a poor man, a rejected man, sorry, what does it feel, sir? In his family. But he wanted to break through. What does it feel, sir? He used to pray, he used to seek God in Psalms. Yeah, that's why he wrote the book of Psalms. He used to be a great worshiper. In fact, he's the most greatest worshiper in the Bible. Yeah? So, one day, I believe, like, as a human being, he wanted to break through in life. Let me tell you, there is a language that breakthrough speaks. Do you know the language of a breakthrough? You know, sometimes we fast, we pray, we give, we fast, pray, give, but you don't see the breakthrough because we don't understand the language that breakthrough speaks. The language of a breakthrough is your testimony. The Bible says that by the word of their testimony, the enemy was defeated. By the word of their testimony, the enemy was defeated. Yeah? So if you want to break through, you have to break through the second heaven. Yeah, you have to make sure that you pierce. You make sure that you make a sign of the second heaven for a breakthrough to come your way, for you to access the third heaven, where the Lord Almighty is. And that second heaven is broken through the word of our testimony. Yeah? And David, when he was taking food to his brethren in the battleground, he saw that the Israelites, the army of Israel was rebels. Yes, that army was fearsome. Yes, why? Because there was a giant, a champion from God, whose name was Goliath. So this man was too strong and he was invincible when it comes to warfare. He was a pagan from Philistine. He was a champion. That's what the Bible calls him. 9 feet tall, too strong, tamagant. And he was a blabberer also. So the story continues that wherever this man used to stood in the battleground, the Israelites used to shrivel, used to shrink and run away, including Saul, their king. Why? Because they used to face this man through the same way he used to face them. That is through horses and chariots. That is against the Bible. The Bible says that God blesses he who does not depend on horses and chariots by the name of God Almighty. So the children of God, the children of Israel, were trying to fight Goliath through Goliath techniques, through the techniques that Goliath already know. That was through horses, chariots, spears, and bows. What else if you sir? And that's why the Bible says that you cannot pay evil by evil or by good. Sometimes you have to fight your enemy by goodness, by good things that the Lord has done unto you. Sometimes you have to fight poverty, not by fighting with your own physical hands or mind, but by the good things that the Lord has done unto you, and that is your testimony. Yeah? So the Bible says that when David saw Goliath, he remembered a testimony in his life. He was one day in the game, yes, and found out that there was a lion that wanted to devour his sheep that he was taking care of. He pursued it and killed it. That's the first testimony. The second testimony is, he saw a bear coming to devour the sheep that he was taking care of. So he pursued it and grabbed it by the beard, and by its beard, and killed it. That is a testimony. So when he was living in his life, he was living with the testimony. Not with how much he fasted nor prayed, because even the devil fasts and prays. Not because he gives, because even the devil worshiper gives, but because of the testimony that was in him. And that testimony was, the Lord Almighty in heaven gave him power to kill a lion and a bear. Do you have a testimony? Do you have a testimony? I want to ask you, sir. Your testimony is the greatest weapon in the heavenly arsenal that you can use, or that the Lord can use to break through over your enemies. What else is curious, right? So David asked, what will happen to anyone who will slay this man? And they responded and told him, the king will reward him mightily with gifts and favor. So David said, I have to face this giant. I have to make sure that I face this giant, not because of my personal gain, but I want to free my fellow brethren in Israel. How many times have you ever fought a battle that will free your fellow brethren in that church that you go to, in that family that you come from, in that neighborhood that you live? How many times have you yearned, yes, to fight their battles and make them a success? To that student, to that class that you attend, how many times have you yearned to fight for them? Then he said to himself that I will slay this man. Not because I'm strong, not because I'm trained in any military training. Yes, but I'm going to face this giant through the testimony of killing a bear and a lion. By the mighty power of Jesus Christ, I will face their giant. Let us see the power of testimony. 1 Samuel 17, 36. 1 Samuel 17, 36. Your servant slew both the lion and the bear. And this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them, seeing he has defied the Lord, seeing he has defied the armies of the living God. Seeing he has defied the armies of the living. Who are the armies of the living God? The armies of the living God are your brethren in Christ. Any believer, anyone who believes in the name of God, he is part of the army of God Almighty. So, if anything, they are trying to threaten one army, one soldier of Christ. Yes, as a fellow soldier, and you have to fight for that soldier. Maybe you are a fight to your fellow brethren away to your breakthrough. What else if you sir? Yes, you need to fight that poverty. Yes, that is defying the Lord of that soldier of Christ that you minister with him in the same church, that lives in your neighborhood, that you come with from the same family, not generation. You have to fight that battle for that person. How? Through your testimony. Do you have a testimony? He who has a son has a testimony. Yes, I was like this some few days ago, but the Lord saved me through that situation. There was a season that I lived without a job, without employment, without any business, but I maneuvered. There was a day that my husband ran away from me and didn't get any support from anyone, but my children went to school and they used to feed. Yeah, there was a day that I was sick in a situation, and I was in a situation that I can't even take myself to the hospital, but the Lord healed me that day. There was a day that I ran out of money completely. Yes, but I survived the whole year in a way that I cannot explain. So if that happened to me, it can happen to you. If that happened to me, it can happen even more to you and to me and to them. So I'm standing with that testimony to face my challenges in life. Sometimes I don't need that fast. Sometimes I don't need that long prayers. Sometimes I don't need that altar. Sometimes I need to stand with the testimony and combat my enemies, and combat the enemies who are fighting my fellow armies, my fellow soldiers in Christ. Yes, I will use my testimony to fight my giants. And whenever I fight my giants with my testimony, I will walk over them. I will break through in Jesus' name. Sometimes what you need is your testimony. How did I make it? For all the years, of all those 4 years, yes, all those 5 years, my husband and I were living without a job, but we used to make it anyway. And today, what about today? Yes, my husband has just told me that he has lost his job. Do you think that the Lord will ever leave us nor forsake us? The Lord who did it 4 years ago is going to do it today. What a situation. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, that judgment stands in your way in form of losing your job, in form of sickness, in form of rejection, in form of mistiming. But I want to encourage someone today. Just remember a simple testimony. Yes, and thank God, I made it those days. What about today? I haven't reached this place. You haven't taken me this far to leave me destroyed by this giant. I'm standing with that testimony to face my giant. And once I stand with that testimony, this giant is defeated. And once it is defeated, I'm telling you, my life will never be the same again. David was rejected, isolated, and forgotten by his family members. Wherever he goes, he used to smell like goats and sheep, because that was his lifestyle. He used to sing alone in the bush like a madman. So he was totally insane, according to the logic mind. But the Bible says, he stood with his testimony and said, yes, they have mocked me. They have done evil against me. I know that I'm not perfect. I have weaknesses, but they have judged me. But I don't care about it. What I know is I have a testimony. I have a testimony. I know that my God is real. Why? Because I've seen him. I've been seeing him in my dreams. I prayed and I felt the power. So I don't need any explanation that my God is real. So the sickness that is attacking my body today, I'm facing him with the testimony that I saw in dream, that he is real and he's alive. I'm standing with that testimony that he once healed me. I'm standing with that testimony that he showed me the light. I'm standing with that testimony that he fed me when I was broke. I'm standing with that testimony that he transformed me, he changed me, and now he who was despised is a somebody. I'm facing my Goliath with my testimony. And as I face my Goliath with my testimony, he will be destroyed, he will be slain, and my life, and my life, and my life will never be the same again. Whoever stands with his or her testimony, his or her life will never be the same again. Your life may be stagnated. You may be operating somewhere like in a cocoon. No growth, no breakthrough. For 20 years, 30 years serving God in truth and in spirit, but nothing seems to work. Yes, but I'm telling you, keep on standing with your testimony. The more you stand with your testimony, the most likely you are breaking through. You are breaking through that cocoon of loneliness, solitude, rejection, and failure. The more you stand with your testimony, the more you are given even that chance to face your Goliath by King Saul. The more you stand in your testimony, is the, let me tell you, it was not easy for Saul to risk the destiny of Israel as a king to give an untrained person to fight a Goliath who was a threat to his kingdom. Because when a David was to lose, the whole kingdom of Saul was to be taken captive, and maybe Saul was to be slain. Amen. Amen. It was not easy. Imagine President Uhuru Kenyatta anachukua mvule ajaenda military, ajaenda na police training, ana any combat training. And I remember now, you are going to face President Yoweri Museveni from Uganda. Na akikuua, Kenya imeuzwa. Uganda inachukua Kenya. But ukimuua, sisi tunachukua Uganda. You know, it is illogic. Because Israel had an army. The Bible says that an army could have a very strong man, could have a regular squad, could have a elite squad, could have rangers, could have those soldiers who are very strong. But Saul had a risk. Saul is risking and giving David that chance. You know, let me tell you, sometimes, for your breakthrough to happen, for you to fight the enemy that is holding your life, it takes a conviction or a convincing spirit that will allow your soul to allow you to fight that giant and destroy it. For you to be free, and for the soul to be free, for your family to be free, for your children to be free. Maybe there is a giant in your family too. There is a giant in your village that you can't just face him like that. You need to go through someone and beg that person, please give me authority, give me permission to face this giant. Maybe if I destroy this giant, our entire family will be delivered. What are you saying?
Amen.
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 For example, in our villages, in many African cultures, kuna kogana strongholds. So you know that. Kuna kogana witches. So you know that. Wale wameshana kwa kila mtu kwa boma, wameroga wa. Kila mtu kwa boma, wanasikia audio kusema. If I may put it that way. Alafu unatoka Nairobi unasema wacha niende niombe huyu mtu akufe. Bwana asifiwe. Wale wazee wako hapa wanakuambia mtu sisi babu yako alijaribu. Nyanya yako alijaribu. Mandugu za baba yako alijaribu. And this ako akaja. Sasa wewe mtu mwenye wa Nairobi hata ujielewi. Do you think that you can destroy this witch? Hiyo bomo wachana na hiyo bomo tunaijua. Inaogopewa hii area. Do you think mtu anaweza kupatia ruhusa ya kwenda kufind that person? Hata kwambia eh hey, wewe na Nairobi fanya shughuli zako. Mambo ya vile yuachie watu wao. Isn't it? Yeah, what has it been? It is the Spirit of God. I'm convinced that it is through the power and the Spirit of God that was in David that convinced Saul to give David permission to face Goliath. Okay? Because nothing just happens. This is a destiny of a nation that is being given out of the hands of an untrained military man. Yes, we know that we are untrained in matters of magic, in matters of rituals, in matters of rites and taboos. We are totally untrained. Because most of us, maybe we have not lived in the village for long. No matter what we lived in the villages, maybe we never connected to such certain things. And someone is telling you that you are a breakthrough to this family. Through this person, this family can be delivered. Yet you know nothing about magic. You have never even seen a demon with your own eyes. You have never seen a witch doctor with your own eyes. But someone is telling you that this novice, yes, this person who has no, who this amateur, this person who has no experience in Mother Spiritual. How can he fight and win over these strongholds, over these yokes that are fighting our family? It is impossible. But David stood up with a testimony. And said, yes, I was not trying to kill a lion, but I killed it. But then we were Simba, back at the university, we were going to zoology. Isn't it? Don't you go to wanyama? Don't you go to the mnyama? You attack? I'm going to go to the mnyama. Is that true? So David didn't go and train anything. He was just a novice. He was just an amateur. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. But in his heart, he said, I don't have that military intelligence. I know nothing about zoology. But I have a testimony. I have a testimony. I have a testimony. And this is my testimony. I killed a bear. I killed a lion. What about this uncircumcised Philistine? Who is defying the Lord of Armies? I have a testimony. Just give me that battleground. And I will stand in that battleground with my testimony. Not my degrees, not my experience, not my education, but my testimony. Sometimes you need to stand in your life, not by how much you have learned it, not by what you have, not by who is backing you up, but by your testimony. Those are the ugonjwa fulani uliingia kwa mwili. As a test. We have lived in Zimbabwe for 5 good years. I tried to pray. The more I pray, the more the Lord is to tell me, I've already healed you. And the more he's to tell me, the more the Lord is to tell me that I've already healed you, the more I felt the pain. Hey, that thing was really stressful. For 5 good years, praying, fasting, nothing happens. Spending all nights praying, seeking God, nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. But I remember for all those years, I used to stand there with a testimony, telling God, there was a day that I had a similar medical condition. Another serious medical condition. You hear me? There's another day that I had another problem, medical condition. You hear me? What about this one? I know that through what you did to me, you will do it to me also. So you will heal me one day. You will heal me. Back at you, it reached a point that I really watch up or bear you high. I just say, I never prayed about it again. I'll just stand with the testimony. I will just stand with the testimony that I have. I'm telling you, the day that disease vanished, I can't even explain. The day that sickness vanished, I can't even explain. Why? Sometimes there are issues in life that needs a testimony. There are issues in life. There are strongholds in life. There are conditions in life that can only be defeated by your testimony. There are issues in life that can only be defeated by the testimonies you stand for your fellow believers. Yes, if the Lord did it to me, he will do it to Brother Basi. He will do it to Brother Uchuka. Today he's suffering. He don't have a job, he don't have money, but I'm standing with Brother Uchuka through the testimony that happened to me. Do you see how he prays? Do you see how committed he is in the church? I was poor than him. I was lonely than him. I was despised than him. So through my testimony, I'm standing with my brother Joseph Machoka. I'm standing with my brother Basia. I'm standing with Pastor Walsh. I'm standing with Pastor Tom. Through the testimony that I have, I know that if it works on me, it will work with them. Amen. Why? Because I have a testimony. Amen. Use your testimony wisely. Amen. Use your testimony wisely. Amen. Sometimes when you face challenges in life, start with your testimony. I'm here to move on in his idea. Kutoka hiyo siku mpaka saa hii. Ni yule ana mtu kwa njia. Exit when you got a shida. Why? Because the Lord stood with me. Nimekosa kazi for those years, but the Lord stood with me. what people used to fight me, including my husband, ran away from me. But the Lord stood with me. My wife betrayed me. But my children are still schooling, are still going to school, and they're still clean, they're still eating. The Lord stood with me. My people rejected me, sidelined me. But I'm still standing. Why? Because the Lord stood with me. So what about today that I'm facing this? Even in this situation, the Lord will still stand with me. He will still stand with me. Why? Because I have a testimony. A testimony is not a testimony. A deal is a declared testimony. If you have to have the kingship mind, the mind of a king or any person who wants to be a king has to be a person of testimonies. Nebuchadnezzar the pagan. Let me finish with Nebuchadnezzar. Nebuchadnezzar the pagan king. He used to brag a lot. He used to say, that is it this not Babylon the Great that I've made in my hands? I, Nebuchadnezzar, the son of Nabopolassar, is this not the kingdom that established myself? Who dare try to stand before? So he used to stand with testimonies that he had in his past life to stand against any obstacle that used to stand in his way. Where are Nebuchadnezzar's of today? I think that's why the Lord loved him so much, because he was a man of testimonies. There is a God of Daniel, and it's not another testimony. I know Daniel will be in a position to translate this vision. I know Daniel will make it, because he is a real God. I have my gods, but he is greater than mine. His God is greater than mine. Sorry. What else if you say?
Amen.
This man, Nebuchadnezzar, used to live and stand with his testimonies, even though he was a pagan. And then he was later saved by God. In the book of Daniel, chapter 4, the last part of Daniel, chapter 4, he was saved. Why? Because God loves those who stand with testimonies. No one can stand with a testimony that will ever be defeated. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Let me repeat this. No one can ever stand with a testimony and later be defeated. A testimony, Let me tell you, who does it, Jesus? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's why I'm going to say, there is nothing good in anger. Amen.
Amen.
This is a miracle. That is a miracle. Yeah? So if the Lord has been feeding you for all those years, thank him. That is a testimony. It is not only a testimony, but a great testimony. What does it feel, sir?
Amen.
So if you stand with your testimony, expect to be a king. Expect to be a winner. Expect to succeed. Expect to break through. Because the language that your breakthrough speaks is your testimony. Stand in your feet. for the past testimonies that you have given to me.
Our Goliath. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
If you did it yesterday,
You will do it today, and you will do it tomorrow. In Jesus' name, we will never suffer in our future. We will never be defeated in our present. Because you did it yesterday. Because you did it yesterday. We will never suffer in our present. We will never suffer in our future. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you are with us. You are with us. In our families, in our health, in our finances. You are with us. You are our nearest physician to our sicknesses. You are Jehovah Jireh, our provider to our needs. You are Jehovah Mkadesh, our sanctifier. No matter how many mistakes we will do, no matter how many mistakes we ever did, no matter how many mistakes that we are doing, you will sanctify us, you will rectify us, and rebuke us into our ways everlasting. In Jesus' mighty name, we want to walk in holiness and righteousness. In Jesus' mighty name, you will search us through and through, and find any unpleasant way in us to blot it out, so that we stand in holiness and righteousness. And those who are judging us, those who are insulting us, they will be ashamed and be surprised by your love and grace upon us. In Jesus' mighty name. Oh dear Lord, your love, you never leave your people, you never forsake them. But cause of a latesso volote remini, but cause of a losso. Ole bagasso, but tesso volota, but a sickle, only matasimis. Oh, Jehovah Lord, we will make it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our children will succeed in school in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our marriages will be retained and sustained by your grace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are going to break through, Jehovah Lord, in all areas of our lives, including our finances. In our sitting and uprising, we will see your face. We will see your hand. In Jesus' name. We are not depending on horses and chariots, but we are depending on you through the testimonies that we have ever experienced in our lives. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, because you are great. Thank you, Jesus, because of your victory. I can see victory in the spiritual realm. I can see victory in the spiritual realm. We are just victorious and casting an asset. You are victorious in Jesus' name. You are victorious in Jesus' name.
And in the mighty name of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, you are the Lord who blesses his people. You are the Lord who knows how to lift curses and break asunder any yoke, proclivity, or activity that is making us lag behind. Oh, today we are seeing you, Jehovah Lord.
Yes.
Today we are receiving from you, Jehovah Lord.
Yes.
And now, may the Lord keep you.
Amen.
May the Lord keep you.
Amen.
May the Lord keep you.
Amen.
I can hear you. And may the Lord keep you.
Amen.
And may the Lord bless you.
Amen.
May he make his name shine upon you.
Amen.
And may he be gracious to you.
Amen.
May you receive peace. May you meet them at the center of their needs. In Jesus' mighty name, I can feel the power. I can feel the power of God. I can feel the power within. The power of God is here. The power of God is here. But Casabolosi, I see the power of God in your life, in your talk life, in your health, in your education, in your career, in your marital life, in your love pattern, in all areas of your life. I see the love with the power of God. I see the power of God. I see the power of God. I see the power of God. In the mighty name of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And in the mighty name of the great and only, our divine master, and Jehovah Emmanuel, I see the prayers. I see the prophecies. And I see the sermon. And in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray and believe.